And as you said, he needs to win. His mom is in the house here tonight. How does he deal with the pressure of not having even played, started a game since December 20th, but really needing to keep his head in this one?
Well, thank you so much, Ken. As you said, growing up in Toronto, I was a big fan of the Toronto Maple Leafs in the late 90s to the early 2000s. I'm talking about Darcy Tucker, Curtis Joseph, and especially Ty Domi and Gary Roberts. I really like how they were these gritty, tenacious guys who could get under an opponent's skin, and that's what I tried to do when I ended up playing hockey. You know, if you can't score, you got to be able to do something on the ice. And so those guys certainly had an impact on me. And I would like to know, John Ahlers and Brian Hayward, who were some of your influences to get into the sport of hockey?
Well, thank you so much, Johnny Paul. The Wild to flex their muscles on the power play and even strength. How do you better manage the puck to add to your lead? Joined by Captain Ryan Getzlaff, who had a very good opportunity on a shorthanded breakaway. And for the Ducks, you might be down one goal, but you guys have put up 16 shots. What have you liked about your offensive scheme? Welcome to Stillwater, Minnesota, on the edge of the St. Croix River. This is the 11th edition of Hockey Day Minnesota. Festivities began at 9 a.m. with a full day celebrating the greatest sport on earth. From outdoor high school hockey games, women's college hockey games, to Minnesota Golden Gophers hockey, and of course, our main event, two of the top teams in the Western Conference facing off, the Anaheim Ducks and the Minnesota Wild. But before we head inside Xcel Energy Center, let's send things 1,900 miles west to Honda Center for some more celebrations with our very own Kent French. Kent, take it away.
Now with the win, the Rangers went back to the formula that's worked for them, winning the special teams battle and limiting chances against. Ryan Strome returned from injury and showed his effectiveness on the power play. Chris Kreider continued to flourish his record-breaking year on the man advantage. And the new guy, Justin Braun, potted his first goal as a Ranger, proving he can play on the elusive left side. Bottom line, they win and they right the ship before a gigantic matchup with Pittsburgh on Thursday that will go a long way to deciding home ice in the postseason. To the ice now, heading into the Stanley Cup playoffs, teams want to be carrying as much momentum as possible while also limiting any injuries. But the two aren't always mutually exclusive. Rangers fans remember how important Marty St. Louis was in notching this overtime goal in Game 4 of the 2014 Eastern Conference Final. The Rangers' run came up three wins shy of hoisting the Stanley Cup. Now, on Wednesday, St. Louis made his return to MSG behind the bench of the team he helped send packing 8 years ago, which he admitted pregame was a special event. New York holds a 2-1 series lead over Pittsburgh. It's skill versus skill. Pens aren't as deep. They've had injury issues, but they have experience, and they also have a guy named, Sidney Crosby. The Tampa Bay Lightning booked their ticket to the Eastern Conference Final a week ago, and now they strap in, literally, to see if they're flying to North Carolina or New York, as all eyes are on Game 7 of the Rangers-Canes series.
2-0 Leafs, Brendan Burke, Butch Goring, Jen Botchville. Let's welcome in the fourth member of our broadcast crew, Julie Stewart-Binks, downstairs. Julie, welcome.
Well, Brendan, you guys were talking about John Cooper's demeanor, and I spoke about it with former NFL head coach Bruce Arians, who won a Super Bowl with the Buccaneers in 2020, the same year Cooper won his first Stanley Cup with the Lightning. He said he loves that John Cooper is always level-headed on the bench. He said he never changes his emotion. He's not yelling at players. He gives them information. He said he's the coolest, calmest coach that I've ever seen. I asked him, does he remind you of anyone in the NFL? And he said Bill Belichick, but Bill's a little bit more animated.
Well, thank you for that.
Auston Matthews, he's going to have to deliver. He's actually been very good in this series, certainly in Game 1. Had a couple goals there. Earlier, he spoke with Julie Stewart-Binks.
Auston, other than staying out of the box, what's something else you guys are keying in on for Game 3?
I mean, I think that was a big part of it.
How do you keep the foot on the gas?
Well, that's a good question. It's something that, obviously, a lot of teams, when they get up, they have a tendency to sit back.
So what's the message rest of the game?
Well, listen, this is far from over. This is the playoffs, so, like, nobody's coasting home here.